you hear me okay?
Yes,
good. Okay, so for those of you who do not know what this instrument is, some people do, some have heard me play before, some have seen the instrument before, and some have not. This instrument is called the oud. It's spelled in English, O-U-D, rhymes with food. It's a good way to remember it. And the history of the instrument is that it is the ancestor of the lute. This is a Middle Eastern instrument, an Arabic instrument. It's still the principal instrument in all of the Arabic countries, the Middle Eastern countries. So, where my dad was from Lebanon, my mother from Syria. And this instrument is played through Egypt, Iran, Iraq, Turkey, Armenia. In fact, right now I'm talking to a fabulously talented Turkish oud maker. It's very exciting, beautiful, beautiful work he does. So that's the history of the instrument. Now, some of what I'll play for you tonight is traditional Middle Eastern, and some of what I'll play is not, because what I do is to fuse Middle Eastern and with Western influences such as jazz and blues and even funk. So I'm going to start with a tune. If you were to pick up one of the CDs over there, on the back of the CD, there's a picture that was actually taken by my other son, Stephen. Not the Daniel working the lights up here, but Stephen. And it's a picture of sunrise at Folly Beach. And we suspect he took it after an all-nighter, but he won't admit to it, so we don't know for sure. But it's an absolutely gorgeous photograph, and when I saw it, I wanted to put it on the CD, and I also wrote a piece of music to go along with it. So this is called Folly Sunrise. Thank you. thing when I put this set together. I actually wrote during Hurricane Matthew, so this is one of the more recent ones. And I call it Storm Surge. So, and this one is kind of a combination of Middle Eastern music and surf guitar, if you can imagine. So see if you can picture the hurricane. And this one also, for those of you who are music aficionados out there, this one starts off in a very Middle Eastern scale, but then goes to a Western scale as well for the more funky part.
Thank you.
King of Bossa Nova, or Brazilian jazz. And I think that it's some of the most romantic music on the planet. It's just so amazing. And we have had, twice now, we've had Duda Lucina here, and he'll be here again, along with his most recent musical partner, Heather Rice, who is just amazing. And we have them rescheduled, so if you're on the email list, again, we'll keep you posted on that. So, an instrumental version of a Jobim song called Once I Loved. Thank you.
Thank you.
11 strings. He asked how many strings were on the instrument. There's 10 pairs and a single bass string. Yeah. I'll do one more, since we're stretching a little bit. And let me do it, maybe I'll do two more. I'll do at least one. So this one is a tune that I wrote that is a memory of a great blues guitarist. My favorite blues guitar. How many blues guitar fans in the room? We got at least some. My favorite was Freddie Ken. And Freddie was known as the Texas Cannonball. That was his nickname. So I wrote this in memory of him, but I call it the Beirut Cannonball. This is going to be an Arabic tocsin in a scale called Nahawand. Thank you.
Thank you.